Welcome back to We Are Austin. You know, a picture is worth a thousand words, especially when it comes to your health. Dr. Gregory Connor with ARA shares the many ways they use imaging to get people the help they need. It's nice to see you, Dr. Connor. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
So we're talking about radiology and radiologists, and that's really a term we've all heard a lot, but what do radiologists really do?
Well, a radiologist is a medical doctor who has gone through 4 years of medical school, mm-hmm. and once they get their medical degree in medical school, they then go on to do internship, residency, usually fellowship, many additional years of training to become experts in using medical imaging to diagnose disease and injuries. Mm-hmm. So sometimes radiologists are thought of as the doctor's doctor because usually we are the doctor that you're primary care doctor might turn to for assistance as a consultant for assistance to try to get to the bottom of what's going on with the help of the many medical imaging studies that we perform.
Right. And what are some of those different imaging studies? I know, like CT scans.
Exactly.
MRI,
So you know, one of the most common and the basics that people think of are x-rays. So mm-hmm. we do a lot of x-rays. We do mammography for screening of breast cancer. And then we do many different more advanced imaging studies that include ultrasound, CT scans, MRI, PET scans.
And so all that's kind of housed under this umbrella of radiology,
which
I think is really good to know kind of where that's all coming from.
So part of that training, we all as radiologists learn to interpret all of those studies.
Okay.
And then many of us go on and do some further kind of sub-specialization where you really learn to become an expert in just a few of those imaging modalities.
Neat, and able to diagnose something really specific.
Exactly.
So tell me kind of what you think is exciting in this field right now. Like, what does the future look like of radiology?
Well, one of the things that we're very excited about is being able to bring to our community 3D mammography.
Yeah.
And we now are able to do screening mammograms looking for breast cancer, where we are really able to look at layers of the breast tissue in a very precise way that wasn't possible until very recently.
Mm-hmm.
And it's kind of a revolutionary improvement in the detection of breast cancer. So we're finding breast cancers much earlier, at an earlier stage where they're more easily treated.
Yeah, that's really good to hear. Anything else on the forefront like that?
Another area that we're very excited about is the interventional procedures that we perform. I was mentioning how different radiologists end up subspecializing. Mm-hmm. We have some radiologists who subspecialize actually in image-guided procedures. So they, after doing a four-year residency where they learn how to diagnose disease, then they also learn how to use the imaging as a guide to do certain treatments.
So interesting.
So we're doing a lot of vein therapy in the legs for varicose veins and things where we use precise image guidance to close those veins up in a very minimally invasive way.
Wow, that is so impressive. So you were kind of speaking to it earlier, but where does a radiologist kind of fall in the landscape of the medical profession in general?
Well, yes, as I was saying, you know, one of the exciting things about being a radiologist is that at some point in almost everyone's life, I end up getting involved in trying to help them, whether they realize it or not. But most people at some point in their life are going to need some medical imaging to help their doctors figure out what's going on. Sometimes it's just for a screening purpose, like a mammogram. They're having no problems.
Yeah.
But we're still going to be involved in your lives. And sometimes some patients don't realize that because oftentimes we're behind the scenes. You come in and you get your imaging study performed and you've got to get on to the rest of your day. So you may not necessarily interact with the radiologist that's there. But behind the scenes, we're helping your doctor get to the bottom of what's going on in your health.
Yeah, that's really neat. Dr. Connor, thanks so much, and thanks for the role you play. So we'll put some info on the screen about how people can find ARA in the Austin area. You guys have been here for a long time, really serving the community. You can head to that website or call the number you see on the screen to book appointments. Thank you for
educating
us that. We'll see you soon.
Appreciate it.
Stick around, an Oscar winner.